Hey, what's up everybody? Xul's here, and in this video, I'm going to be checking out one of the sports cameras. It's a knockoff of a GoPro. It's called the CAMPARK. A pretty cool camera here. I used it extensively before I did this review, so that I could do a good review on it. I used it for biking, brought it to Hawaii with me, went underwater with it, did a lot of different things, so I'm going to show you a lot of different footage. This thing came with a lot of different straps and attachments to be able to attach it to various items. The only thing it didn't come with was a extension stick, so you can buy one of these. This is a dollar store one, actually, and allows you to get closer to things. So let's jump right into this. Here is the actual camera, the CAMPARK mini camera. It's very small, as you can see. Fits into the palm of my hand. We'll go ahead and power it up. The power is on this side here. You press the power button, hold it down for a second, and it will light up and power up for us. So you use this button to go into different modes here. This is the picture mode. They have a slow motion mode, which removes the sound. So if you use it, there will be no sound. And there's the playback. You can see what you've played. And then, of course, an options menu, which gives you a bunch of different functions as far as options go. To start it, you just press the top button here, OK. And that will actually start recording. And you can see it starts recording in the bottom there. The formats of it, let's see here, we'll jump into the formats, go to options here. So you can go all the way up to 4K at 30 frames per second, you can do 2.7 at 30 frames, and then my favorite is actually the 1080p at 60 frames per second. That really does really good resolution. Same thing with pictures, you can do up to 16 megapixel pictures. The pictures actually look really good. And this is completely waterproof once it is in its case. So the case is right here, a full plastic case, and we'll go ahead and stick it in its case. So you pop it in like so, close the back door, and then seal it. The way you get it out is you actually push, you pull on this here, and you push up on this part here like that to release it. So once it's in its case, it is completely waterproof. And then the buttons, of course, line up with these, so you can use them like so. Very cool. Yeah, so I'm going to show you a bunch of different footage that I actually took with this camera. See if you like it. It comes with an extra battery, which is nice, because you will run out of battery power. There's an option in the menu that you can have the battery fade after a minute, which I suggest doing, because a lot of times you don't really need to see the viewfinder. It comes with a ton of different attachments for this thing. Like I said, the one thing you want is a handheld, because it didn't come with that. And you can use one of these attachments and then screw it onto a handheld stick like this. And you get an extension. You can take selfies and go underwater with it, etc. $1 at the dollar store for this extension. Don't recommend it, though, because I think this thing is going to break. I'd buy a better one. It doesn't have a dashboard suction cup thing, but you can buy one of these. I got this on Amazon for $3.99. Had to wait, like, 2 weeks to get it shipped, but it actually works really well and attaches to my dash, and then it hangs. Yeah, it's a really cool attachment, so highly recommend picking up these two items for a price tag of about $5. As far as attachments come, it comes with a ton of attachments. It's got a bike clamp attachment. It's got the straps for a helmet, if you'd like to do that. It has a bunch of different clip-ons and a bunch of different swivels and all kinds of things. It even has an extra case thing if yours gets scratched. Comes with twisty ties, and it comes with a metal bracket in case you think you're going to lose your thing. And it actually comes with a lens cleaner here too as well. And it comes in this nice extra case right here. So it comes in its own little cool case, which is very nice. Yeah, highly recommend this camera. I mean, I used it the entire trip in Hawaii, and it really produced some good video. And I'm going to jump into the video right now and show you some of the clips and show you how awesome this camera did run for me. Now, this camera is at a $69.99 price tag, $70 basically. It's got a number of different attachments, and it does have an instruction booklet that came with it too as well. You can see the sports. It just says sports on it, and XDV user model. And then, of course, it's got the whole operations and how to do everything in here. I actually found the menu in this camera to be a bit better than the GoPro, which I do have. And then it has a labeling for all the attachments and tells you what they are. which is pretty cool. And it tells you how to use them, etc. So definitely very helpful. For the $70 price tag on this camera, I definitely highly recommend it. And I'm gonna go jump into some more video about this camera. Yeah.
Smell it. Smell the